When Jeff Bezos unveiled his space business Blue Origin, many people believed that it would dominate the space race with his unique space project. Just last month, NASA officially selected SpaceX for the $2.9 billion human landing system, beating Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin. This was just the latest in strings of defeats recorded by Jeff Bezos' space company. With SpaceX's total dominance of the rocket industry, do you think Blue Origin is a complete failure? And will they be able to keep up with the space race? Welcome to Futured. Today, we'll look at Blue Origin and if it will be a complete failure or will be a success. Before we do, subscribe to our channel to get updated with everything on future technology, Elon Musk, or SpaceX. Well, it has been 22 years since Blue Origin was founded, and it has considerably failed to meet expectations. While many people still believe in the firm, the fact is that it does not seem to be changing its fortunes anytime soon. There are many factors why Blue Origin hasn't stayed faithful to its promises, but the most crucial is related to its founder. The billionaire Jeff Bezos is the only owner of the space firm. Even his strongest rival, SpaceX's Elon Musk, has declared that no space enterprise can be profitable with 100% private finance, something most experts disagree with, and he might be correct. Blue Origin is one of Jeff Bezos' numerous businesses, and although visiting outer space has long been a goal of his, keeping up with his many commitments has proven difficult. He's accused of preferring Amazon over Blue Origin. Although Amazon is just 6 years old, the e-commerce site is well ahead of Blue Origin in terms of effect and profit. The wealthy CEO even said to news reporters that Amazon is the most important project he is working on. Although he said he is interested in Blue Origin, he hasn't shown any proof of this when opposed to Musk and SpaceX. It's difficult to imagine the firm developing at the rate it's going due to the owner's lack of full-time direction. Another factor that might lead to its demise is its fixation with perfection. Symbolism is essential to the brand. The feather in its emblem indicates accuracy, which should be employed in space travel. But this is taken quite seriously by the firm. When the rocket New Shepard landed, it was a sight, owing to the company's investment of millions of dollars in the landing system's research and development. The rocket landed upright, but that's all about they can say about the time, work, and billions they put into it. The New Shepard's landing technology still pales in contrast to others, like SpaceX's Falcon 9. When it comes to failing, just seeing a few videos of failed launches is enough to make anybody nervous. On the other hand, Elon Musk and the SpaceX crew have learned to laugh at it and use it as motivation to go to space quicker. Musk's view is that invention arises from a series of failures, and it's true. In October 2020, the crew will celebrate their 100th successful flight. Even smaller enterprises with less exposure are defeating Blue Origin at their own game, the Rocket Lab. Rocket Lab has virtually completed the design of its Electron rocket, which will be powered by cheaper 3D printed engines. In contrast to other space firms, Blue Origin's purpose with the New Shepard is more like recreational activities. The New Shepard is suborbital, allowing wealthy individuals to go to the farthest reaches of space and return to Earth without having explored space. It was designed to take thrill addicts with rich finances on an excursion to see the planet from a suborbital vantage point. The business intends to generate more money with suborbital excursions, although it's unknown how much such flights would cost. The only clue we get is from Virgin Atlantic, which sells tickets for $250,000. It's fair to presume that Blue Origin will charge within this range. The business has planned to launch its first crewed flight in 2019, but it never happened. Because of the pandemic outbreak, 2020 was likewise dormant, and 2021 did not seem to get any better. Apart from people, the Origin may concentrate on bringing client payloads to fix in orbit, as it has been for some time. They've struggled to stay up to expectations even then. Blue Origin has excessive ambition for a firm, but it has yet to deliver on any of its promises. The corporation invests a lot of time and money into several space programs. Jeff Bezos has operated his firm in near total secrecy. Only five people were aware of the firm when it was founded in 2000. However, the ideas that the corporation does share are either not carried out swiftly enough or are abandoned entirely. This leads us to another reason for the company's downfall: a lack of quickness. The employer has put a significant amount of money into Blue Origin. According to estimates, Bezos invests a stunning $1 billion from Amazon shares into Blue Origin each year to meet their financial demands. However, their financial stability may have made them less deliberate in their advancement. In its proposals for government contracts, the corporation isn't as aggressive as others. According to industry analysts, this is due to a lack of drive caused by the boss's free money. Other businesses like SpaceX do not have that luxury, and it shows in their additional efforts. it is obtaining government contracts, which contributes to their fast expansion. The corporation collaborates closely with NASA, one of its most important customers, to launch many cargo and personnel to the International Space Station. Elon Musk has claimed that government financing is critical to his plan to populate Mars. The business is working on a reusable spacecraft on Mars in 2024. While Bezos has declared that he does not favor humanity's expansion to Mars, he fantasizes about space colonies. His anticipated project delivery deadlines, on the other hand, are not specified. Most of his Blue Genesis history is based on a hypothesis from past deliveries. Because there are no dates, the corporation is not held responsible. As a result, they can operate at a slower pace. They do have one thing going for them, their collection of spaceships. The business also launched the Blue Moon, which can transport 6 tons of goods to the moon's surface. It's also equipped with self-driving software and can operate without the presence of a person. Also, the United States Air Force and Blue Origin negotiated a launch shelf agreement. Tragically canceled in December 2020, this was a 6-year public-private partnership in which the government and the contractor would invest in space technology to compete with the National Security Space Launch Program. The initial deal called for Blue Origin to be paid $500 million over 6 years. After obtaining nearly half of the money, they lost out to SpaceX and ULA because they could not get a National Security Space Launch procurement contract. It was agreed that several firms would be dropped if they did not obtain a procurement contract from the start. ULA is currently working on a new rocket, with 60% of the contract for the Air Force, the VULCAN CENTAUR. Because of its space firm Rocket Origin and SpaceX, Blue Origin must have been disregarded for the contract. The two most influential firms are developing heavy orbital rockets in the space race. However, when compared to Blue Origin, SpaceX is more powerful. While official statistics on the entire cost of the rocket remain unknown, Elon Musk of SpaceX claims that it will cost $5 billion to create. However, it would be less expensive than the Falcon. Another point of contention is the company's readiness to go to Mars. Since 2017, SpaceX has made it apparent that its primary emphasis is on the Mars expedition, and it has already begun planning rudimentary voyages for 2022. By 2050, SpaceX hopes to have built Martian cities, and it's already helping to collect knowledge on how to do it. In the space race, Blue Origin has been a bit of a slacker, also because the Amazon CEO hasn't said much about his space enterprise. SpaceX's deadlines may be moved about frequently, but they have a reputation for virtually consistently delivering. It's difficult to see Blue Origin taking on any decision other than the tourist position they've settled for, given their long history of mediocrity and inconsistency. Will Jeff Bezos and Blue Origin be able to catch up to the rest of the group in space? Will the corporation realize its vision of bringing space projects to life? Please share your thoughts in the comments box below. That's all for now. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get updated with everything on future technology, Elon Musk, or SpaceX. Thank you for watching.